Good morning and welcome to our virtual service on this, the first Sunday in October 2020. We've now moved on into autumn and the weather and the gardens are showing signs of this. It can be difficult to accept, as only 2 weeks ago we were on holiday in Shropshire, about 15 miles from Ludlow, and we found it too hot to sit outside to read our books in the sunshine. It was lovely to see the changing colour of the leaves on the trees, especially as the bright sunshine seemed to amplify the contrasting effect. We had a herd of cattle consisting of a bull and cows with their calves very close to our accommodation, and it was lovely to watch the calves at play. Our accommodation was on a hillside with beautiful views down into the valley and onto a range of hills on the other side. It certainly reminded me of how wonderful a creator is our God, and how fortunate we are to be able to enjoy this part of his creation. Of course, we too are part of God's creation, and a very special part. We are loved by him, and are able to have a broken relationship, which is caused by our sin, restored by trusting in the finished work of the Lord Jesus Christ, when he offered himself as a sacrifice for our sin. And can it be, as a Christian hymn written by Charles Wesley, Diarmaid MacCulloch, an English historian and academic who specialises in ecclesiastical history, suggests that this hymn is one of the best loved of Wesley's 6,000 hymns. Charles Wesley wrote it in 1738 to celebrate his conversion, which he regarded as having taken place on the 21st of May that year. The words of this hymn really express the reality of God's love for us, manifested in his Son. And can it be that I should gain?
Thank you.
Let us pray. Loving Heavenly Father and Almighty God, we come to you through the person of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. We thank and give you our praise for all that you've done for us in the past and are continuing to do for us today. We thank you especially for your plan of salvation established through the sacrifice of your Son on that cross at Calvary. We thank you that we can now have a relationship with you, whereby we can address you as our Heavenly Father. We pray for each member of our church, that we may really feel the presence of your Holy Spirit within us, as you have promised, to guide, strengthen and comfort us. And may the fruits of the Spirit be reflected in our lives. Thank you, Father, that so many of your people are able to access online church services and other Christian content during these unprecedented times. Please continue to connect us all with faith-filled people, that our spiritual lives may be deepened and we may know your peace. Thank you, Father, for our NHS. Please bless all those who work in it. May they be strengthened both physically and mentally and be aware of your love. God of love, please watch over residents and staff in care homes, greatly affected by the coronavirus situation, especially where families are unable to visit. Grant continuing compassion and fortitude as they face so many ongoing practical and emotional challenges. We pray too for carers in the community, that they may also be able to give the care and compassion to those for whom they provide this service. Please help us now to feel your presence with us as we continue to worship you, and may we be receptive to what you have to say to us today. We ask these things in the name of Jesus. Amen. Let us now worship our Lord Jesus Christ as we sing the hymn written by Matt Redman, committing our lives once again to our Saviour.
Of the dead of love. my every part. Lord, receive the sacrifice of a broken heart.
We are now proceeding into a time of celebrating communion, concentrating on the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Let's begin by reading from Hebrews chapter 9, verses 11 to 15. When Christ came as high priest of the good things that are already here, he went through the greater and more perfect tabernacle that is not man-made, that is to say, not a part of this creation. He did not enter by means of the blood of goats and calves, but he entered the most holy place once for all by his own blood, having obtained eternal redemption. The blood of goats and bulls and the ashes of a heifer sprinkled on those who are ceremonial unclean sanctify them so that they are outwardly clean. How much more then will the blood of Christ, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself unblemished to God, cleanse our consciences from acts that lead to death, so that we may serve the living God. For this reason, Christ is the mediator of a new covenant, that those who are called may receive the promised eternal inheritance, now that he has died as a ransom to set them free from the sins committed under the first covenant. Now let us sing the chorus that acknowledges the cleansing power of Jesus' blood. It's your blood that cleanses me.